welcome to Hot Ones, the show with hot questions and an even hotter chip. Today I'm joined by a very talented technician. Shall we begin?
Hi there, my name is Seth Conroy. I've been professionally installing since 2012, where I started at Best Buy in Cincinnati, Ohio. I learned a lot and developed a passion for the 12-volt industry there before I moved in 2016 to Jimmy's Car Stereo of Auburn, Alabama. I stayed there until the end of 2019 when I moved to Atlanta to further evolve my skill set at Cartoons of Atlanta. In the spring of 2021, life changed and sent me and my wife back to Auburn, Alabama, and back to Jimmy's Car Stereo. I've been with those guys for the last 18 months. Bottoms up. Oh my God.
All right, Mr. Conroy. What would you say your biggest challenges and accomplishments have been this year, both personally and professionally?
In the past year, one of my biggest challenges personally has been finding a work-life and home-life balance. No one said it was easy being married and also being so passionate and a moderate workaholic. My wife and I have noticed that as time has gone on, I've gotten better at being more present at home and not constantly enthralled with 12-volt this and 12-volt that. My biggest professional accomplishment this year has been all the custom fabricated jobs I've done. When I was at Cartoons, I was surrounded by techs who built crazy, big, involved custom jobs day in and day out. It was a typical Tuesday there. Jimmy's is a bit different, whereas the volume and complexity of the custom jobs I do is a bit lower. That being said, this year, I started off strong with a custom rear center console enclosure for a 2017 GMC Sierra, designed, fabricated, and built by myself with input from some of the other greats in the industry. It's a hot chip. Then I moved on to doing custom door panels in a 2012 Maxima, where I fabricated pods for all four doors to fit 8-inch DS18 mid-ranges. That built my confidence up even more, where I then felt comfortable taking on a full custom door job in a 2019 Dodge Charger. I did a super tweeter, acrylic backlit that was laser engraved, and also did a 10-inch mid-bass driver. I designed, I upholstered, fabricated, and I tuned it all. I ran wires into the door. I impressed myself. And then my latest one is a full stack fab underseat subwoofer enclosure that I did in a 2019 F350. It has two JL 12-inch subwoofers. I wrapped that. I made a beauty panel with the OEM Platinum logo flushed into the front of the box. Thing jammed. It was really cool, and I was really impressed that I made something that was like an MTI box. I feel really accomplished about stepping out of my comfort zone instead of doing drop-ins.
Wow, that was a great answer. So, how would your coworkers and customers describe your impact to the team?
My coworkers would describe me as a hardworking individual who has a passion for the 12-volt industry. That passion has bled in to the rest of my team, showing them that we can raise our standards, we can still be profitable, and we can be competitive with other shops within the nation. My customers, my long-term customers that I knew from the first time at Jimmy's, have noticed that my amp installs have gotten cleaner, they've gotten more professional looking, and at the end, it's justified an uptick in the cost of labor that we've been doing. So as a whole, I'd say I'm positively impacting both my clients and my coworkers and the shop I work for by being more profitable.
Can you describe your installation specialty and also your philosophy?
My installation specialty is meeting the higher end standards and then trying to push the envelope further. I don't want to send a job out, even if it is for a 2001 clapped out Honda Civic that looks like just anybody did it down at the car wash for the lowest price they could afford. My philosophy is to make sure that the client is getting premium work, that the work that I'm putting out is justifying the cost, and that I'm always pushing the boundaries of my skill set, and I'm continuing to grow day in and day out, continuing to do better, and that I can lay in bed that night and say, I did my best. I pushed, I tried, and I learned. And ultimately, I believe that philosophy keeps clients coming back.
So what do you want your customers to remember about the installation aspect of your service?
I want my clients to remember a premium experience with a premium level of quality. I want to give them that level of service that they've never had before that keeps them coming back. I want to continually wow them and their friends when they show off what I've done for them.
So who are some other professionals that influence and inspire you?
Oh man, there's a very long list of them. I mean, let's start off with the man, the legend, the mesh man, John Brettel. He continues to impress me day in and day out. I call him up with a question. I ask him, hey, how would you upholster this? How would you build this door panel? He always has an answer, or he'll try to help me work through it if he hasn't encountered that before. Also, within not necessarily working on a job, I ask him a question of, hey, I'm about to do the MEI Industry Awards nomination video. And he says, be original, be yourself, and have fun with it. So, he's number one. Next one up is Chris McNulty. He is a wealth of knowledge, be it electromedia products, fabrication, sales. He's got it all. He also picks up my phone calls. What more can you say about him? He inspires me to become better and to learn more, because I want to be that person that somebody 5-10 years from now is going to say, hey, Seth, I ran into this issue. How do I make this happen? He pushes me to learn more. The next one is Ken Ward. I've been continually impressed by how well he tunes a product or a vehicle, how well he integrates with the OEM system, and how quickly and efficiently he does it. I would love to have that level of knowledge and expertise, and he keeps me pushing further and further to get to that point. The last one is gonna be Ray West. I haven't had much time with him personally. I've trained with him one time, but I see his presence on the forums. I've heard wonderful things about him and just how he is the go-to guy for everything, be it mechanics, 12 volt, sales, professional development. He knows it all. That's a resource that I need to use more. I understand I do, because he is going to help propel my career to the next step. And then Adam Devine, he's amazing. You got Jeff Cantrell. Then you got Christopher Pate, who's got MTI. You got John Justice, a cartoon. I could keep going on, but I think we have to move on to the next question.
All right, Seth. Why do you deserve to be part of the top 50 installers?
I deserve to be in the top 50 installers because I have the drive, I have the passion, and I have the determination to keep growing and to never plateau. Day in and day out, I look at a job that I've done 50 million times and think to myself, how can I be more efficient? How can I be more profitable? How can I be better? Is there anything I could have done differently? So then tomorrow, when I have the same style job, dropping Kenwood speakers in a 4Runner. Okay, well, yesterday we did it this way, but let's try to do it a little bit differently. Maybe it'll be done quicker and better. I know those two don't normally go hand in hand, but I feel like it's something that I can do. And then I don't want my skill set to stop right here. I want to build the crazy things that Dave Koz up at Titan does. I want to build the massive boxes, the A-pillars that you see coming out of MTI. I want to learn the laser industry like Brettel. Eventually, I want to become an Adam Devine where I run this amazing award-winning shop. That is it, guys. Don't do this and try to answer questions. But it has been a blast. I look forward to seeing everybody at the next Knowledge Fest. Here's my workstation, workbench. I got my toolbox right here. Most of my everyday use tools are kept in the top portion. Small screwdrivers, pick tools, sockets, drills and drill accessories. Got panel poppers, T-handles, more pliers and T-handles. Down here I got the screwdrivers with my Torx screwdrivers. Then the rest of my daily use tools are kept right over here in this truck that I'm currently working on. Got the impact, wire strippers, polarity tester, and we got some flush cutters and zero gauge cutters, and my favorite tools, the soldering iron and my colored tape.
Thank you.